Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, I'm going to be telling you guys about 15 tips and tricks that you might not have known about being a bounty hunter in Red Dead Online. So I thought for sure this was going to be the most popular role in the latest Red Dead Online update, but now I'm not too sure. I think that the trader and the collector both are giving the bounty hunter a run for its money. But anyways, today we're going to be focusing on the bounty hunter and some things you might not have known about. Okay, so the first common question I've seen a lot of confusion on is it worth it to keep the bounty target alive? Alive versus dead, and what is the payout difference? Well, if you keep your bounty target alive, you get about 25% more payout at the end. That includes gold, XP, and money. So is it worth it to try and keep the bounty target alive? The answer is yes. Although if you do accidentally kill the bounty target, or if your bounty target is killed by accident, it's not that big of a deal. Like, is it worth it to close your application and shut down the game because you're going to be losing an insane amount of money and gold? The answer is no. Obviously, in a perfect world, you would love to bring in your bounties alive 100% of the time. But in the case that they are killed by your hand or someone else's, it's really not that big of a deal. The only difference is that you deliver them to the outside of the police station, or in some cases, if they're dead, you won't even bring them to a police station. You'll bring them to like a third-party prison wagon, which is kind of interesting. And number two, there's also no way for them to escape, which I guess is nice. That is something you don't have to worry about. Now, speaking of that, a lot of you guys have also been asking me, Mr. Boss, how do I prevent the bounties from escaping? They always seem to jump off the back of my horse. Well, there's two ways in which you can prevent this. Number one would be to purchase the reinforced lasso, but not everyone might have either unlocked it or might not have the funds to do so. One thing you can do to prevent the person from jumping off the back of your horse 100% of the time is you have to hit them. So this is kind of hard to see because the prompt doesn't last very long on the screen, and if you miss it, they'll end up jumping off. But for PlayStation guys, if you hit circle, you will actually sort of elbow the bounty target, and that will stop them from trying to escape. And you typically only have to do that once, and they won't attempt to escape again. And even if they do escape, it's really not all that hard. I mean, the game gives you like an exorbitant amount of time in order to complete these bounty missions, so it's not like you're really all that in a rush in order to get them done. However, transitioning to that, a lot of people have been reporting that if you wait until the very end of the timer, like to when the timer gets below 30 seconds to turn in the bounty, that you'll end up getting more money, gold, and XP. And that is true, but is it necessarily worth it? I think the answer is really no. So the argument people are making is that, again, if you wait until the last 30 seconds or so, you get more money, more XP, and more gold. However, let's just set up a quick example here. So let's say you complete your bounty and you've got 7 minutes remaining. You could turn that in with 7 minutes left and get the normal amount of gold, money, and XP, or you could wait for 6 minutes and 30 seconds, really doing absolutely nothing, and then turn it in at the last possible minute in order to get more money. Sure, you would get more money, but that's not really an efficient use of your time, of that 6 minutes and 30 seconds. So I think it's just as efficient to just do the bounties as quickly as you can, but you also don't have to rush. Take your time, and this is sort of building off of that. I would highly recommend that when you capture the bounty, that you loot every single person that was with him. Not only will you find a ton of normal items and provisions like ammo and dynamite and fire bottles, but you'll also find some pretty rare collectibles as well. I actually mentioned this in my collector tips and tricks video, but the time I spent bounty hunting, I found almost as many collectibles as I did when I was trying to find collectibles as a collector. I mean, it's crazy. Like, these NPCs have arrowheads on them, antique alcohol bottles. They have the cards that you need to collect. It's insane the amount of rare items that they have on them. And even if they don't have rare items, there's a good chance that they've got things like jewelry, gold teeth, bracelets, watches, things that can be sold to Madame Nazar or the fence for an extra profit. So these are things that you can do along the way just to ensure that your bounty trip is a little bit more efficient. So long story short, I wouldn't really bother waiting around until the last minute. Just be efficient with your time. And if you turn them in quickly, you can start another bounty mission instantly because there is no delay. Like when you turn in a bounty mission, the game doesn't tell you you have to wait a little bit. You can simply just grab another one off the board. Now, speaking of that, in case you guys are wondering, there are 3 bounties per town, and there are 13 locations in which you can get a bounty, which means that at one time, there are 39 total bounties. Now, the bounties do regenerate and respawn. I don't know how long it takes. I think it's like an hour in game. There's no way you'll be able to get through 39 bounties in an hour. So essentially what that means is you have an unlimited amount of bounties that you can do back to back to back. You'll basically never run out. Now again, I know what some of you guys are saying, well, Mr. Boss, some of the bounties require that we collect 2 bounty targets at once, and I don't have the bounty wagon, so how can I do that? Have no fear. Even though the game like warns you and says that you need to be a part of a posse or have a wagon before you attempt something like this, it is so easy. Rockstar gives you extra time and they make it super simple in order to just deliver both of the targets at once. You can make it easy and kill both of them. You could tie up one, kill the other. You could tie up both of them. It really doesn't matter at all. It's incredibly easy to do. So even though the game warns you about it, you can go about doing those bounties as well. It's really not that big of a deal. However, what is a big deal and might have an impact on you is the way you go about turning in the bounty will affect your honor. So if you turn in a bounty alive, it will actually give you positive honor or honorable points. And if you turn in a bounty that has been killed, the game will give you dishonorable points. So something to keep in mind right there that if you are trying to be a good outlaw, always bring them in alive. If you're trying to maintain your evil outlaw status, well, you might want to turn them in dead, even though you'll be getting less money. Now, a couple of other things you need to know about the bounties, they can actually fail. So unlike the collectibles where they'll just be there no matter what, it's just up to you to get them, the bounty targets can escape. And if they do escape, the mission will ultimately fail and the timer will stop. Now, again, this isn't that big of a deal, but just know that Rockstar sort of took the training wheels off a little bit and you can fail the bounty missions. You kind of have to go out of your way. Like you basically have to let the target escape or just purposely not catch up to them. But bounties can fail and that's something you might not have known about. Now easily the biggest complaint that I've seen surrounding the bounty hunter role is that it is by far the hardest to rank up. And I agree. And if you are, you know, not sure about if you want to go down the bounty hunter path, just know that it is incredibly difficult to rank up because the only way to earn bounty hunter XP is by doing the bounty hunter missions. Whereas the other roles, like the trader, every time you turn in supplies or do a resupply mission or sell or do some upgrades, boom, that's how you get XP right there. Same with the collector, finding the items, turning in the individual sets, turning in the collections. That gets you XP right there. Whereas there's only one thing to do with the bounty hunting, and that is turn in the bounty. So it is the slowest grind of the bunch. And because of that, it's going to take you a longer time to not only unlock some of the cool cosmetic items that you get for being a bounty hunter, but also some of the other types of bounties that you will encounter. Like the legendary and 5-star bounties, you only get if you're a high enough rank. And also the ability to turn in player bounties, that only happens if you're a high enough rank. You have to be rank 12, which is very difficult to rank up that high. So just keep that in mind that if you haven't started down the bounty hunter role, or if you've been wondering if you're the only one struggling to rank up, that's not the case. Everyone is sort of in that boat where it just seems to be very difficult in order to rank up. But anyways, that right there is 15 or so things you might not have known about being a bounty hunter in Red Dead Online and some tips and tricks along the way. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. What has your experience been being a bounty hunter so far in Red Dead Online. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And be sure to subscribe if you guys are new. You want to stay up to date on all the latest Red Dead Redemption Frontier Pursuits DLC videos that I'm going to be doing over the next couple of days and weeks. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.